Hi there. So running the tables, of course you get independent tables, so we're good on that. You right click on the table, copy, jump across to Excel in your new workbook. You just made a brand new workbook and paste. So the table comes here. Now what you want to do, you open another worksheet here in Excel. So I just drag it across. I call it total. And you take, well, you know, these are your response sets. So I'll put the response set here, and for someone withholding information from you, you say you want it in one table. It's kind of hard to do that because it's many questions, but you would have to do something like this, right? You'd have to do that to ensure that you're not going to get lost somewhere along the way. I'll show you what happens afterwards, and then we take what you want here. Usually it's a valid percent that you would take. When you don't have non-responses, it makes a difference. But in this case, you have all the respondents, so we could take both the frequency and the percentage or the valid percentage. So we want valid percentage, and we throw that here. Okay, so that's number one. It's not finished yet, but I'm just gonna take number two. Copy, just right click, copy. Go to Excel, you could paste on that sheet here. Alright, humiliated already, cool, copy, paste that one here. Then you take this here, paste it here. So we drag this one down, just to make sure that we're covering all the questions, or the parts of the question. We take the percentage, valid percent. Once the two numbers are the same here, like 52, 52, 31, 66, 4.5, we just take this part and paste it here. I don't need this, so let me undo. I don't need to take it, I just need to take this part and paste it here. Okay, so this is something like what you want, but I'm going to show you other variations and you will choose one. All right. This, now I could do a merge and it will keep one. I'll put it in the center. I could merge this. It would say okay, keep one, put it in the center. Okay, so for question one, you see never read sometime blah blah blah. Fair enough, but let me show you another way to do this whole thing. And the next way would be to look at the data. It's going to open. I'm going to look at the data from this perspective. You could do it like this also. Looking at the data from this perspective. Okay, so it's up to you to do it that way. If you do it this way, you could rotate it to do this way afterwards with one click of the mouse. The data could be rotated. But the main issue to me would be why you want all of them together, because you know, I don't know what the questions are, but I don't know, so you have to do what you have to do. Copy this one, bring it to Excel, just use one place to put them down. So that's question three. It's gonna take a lot of work. So in this case, I'm gonna take question three. Put it here. I'm gonna take these responses, put them here. Okay. And then I'm just gonna merge this. Put it in the center. Give me some of that. Okay, so never, sometime, maybe, rarely, monthly, weekly, and daily. To me, you have to make sense of the data. So someone withholding information from you. How is that happening? If I look at it here.
Chitty.
Yo.
I could wear that fruit.
Better look at it from a pie chart. Let me see. See, I'm seeing 55% already. So, this is for you to decide and determine. Just let me know and I'll make videos.